Boom cam. He out here in his big ass cargo van. Like I'm being held prisoner.
It's like people ask me, why in hell did you get that van? Referring to this Assvan racing van before I left for the trip this past weekend. Well, we're done here at Trader Joe's. I think we can go grab some PA cider. Okay, let's do it. Gonna be a little bit of a... It's always a little bit of a challenge backing out of parking lots and shit. It's just kind of hard to see where you're going. And just the fact that you're a long piece of shit here. You're high up. You're looking down on everybody. You're long as fuck. Your exterior is a white. No windows. No nothing. All work, no play. All work, no play environment here. And no one knows. No one knows your true intentions. When you're just all that white. All nondescript. It's like you're a sleeper almost. Let's go to the farm real quick. Grab some cider. Unfiltered, unpasteurized, un-nothing cider. PA. We've already had some Vermont cider this past weekend. But I think that stuff was filtered. Because it was served at a restaurant of all places, so it's gotta be filtered, right? It's gotta be filtered, pasteurized, etc. We're going to the farm. In a racing van. We're not gonna race to the farm, but it's just that this van. I'm telling you, when you get a van like this and have the opportunity to become white van man for even just temporarily for just a weekend, you know, it's an experience beyond just driving a van. It's an experience unto itself. Picking up the van, obviously driving it. Or also when you're hauling everybody else in here. It's an experience. While hauling everybody else and, you know, especially when you're going to go racing. You're going to go racing, right? You see everybody else with their racing vans. Or their cars or whatever's. See everybody else with them and then start having a little fun. Maybe having a little bit too much fun, but it's fun nonetheless. Especially if you get stuck behind a coach bus on a two-lane road, because that's the only road that'll get you over to the next interstate. You're stuck behind a coach bus, that's killing it in the slow department. Once you get on the interstate, Not exactly my racing van, but the other racing van from another school in Central PA and a certain school in Philly. They didn't have a van, they just had a freaking, I think it was a Nissan Versa with a whole bunch of bikes in the back and a very crowded interior. I don't think that one was just getting pushed to the gills. That little Nissan Versa with bikes and five people in it. Once we got on the interstate after leaving the bus that was killing it in the slow department in the dust. Woo! The other van from that other Central PA school just freaking booked it. He didn't want anything to do with me. Or the bus, or that other with that other school in the Versa. I was just playing it cool once we got on the interstate, but I mean, you kind of have to play it cool because it's a pretty heavily trafficked interstate. There's a good amount of fuzz on there. And I just knew if I raced a little bit too much on the interstate, it would be a little bit, it wouldn't end too well. Anybody who was racing a little bit too much on that interstate was just asking to get busted. Not to mention, it's just a waste of fucking fuel. You're just wasting a lot of fuel there. Pretty sure that van was wasting a good amount of fuel when he was booking it past everybody. I eventually caught up to him not very long after. I just maintained my composure back there, and I just easily caught up to him. He had traffic, I didn't. It was funny when we were still on the two-lane road. He was behind. We were the first van in the convoy, so to speak. When we were on the two-lane roads, being stuck behind the bus, we just looked back, and me and my teammate just looked back in our mirror. Or really the back window, because this apparently does have a back window. It's like the only other window it's got. We looked in the back window / the mirror. The other guy in that other van was just gone. The guy riding shotgun, wearing his shades, you know, with his head like cocked over to one side of the headrest, if it even was a headrest. And he was gone. Straight up gone. After a hard day's racing, he was gone. And I'm telling you, once you get a van, particularly a racing van like this, it's a lot more than just being a white van man. It's a lot more than that. Now I understand why that school up in Vermont loves their van. Even though the two most common full-size vans in North America, the Ford E-Series and this piece of shit right here, the Chevy Express, two most common full-size vans, you know, they're so shitty that they're great. And they're awesome. Once you're carrying like more than two people in a van, seats or no seats, woo! Maybe trying to see if anybody else gets sketched out by our presence. All that good stuff. Going the other way on a road that I tend to ride on a good amount. I go the other way, the opposite direction on this road most of the time. I don't think I've gone this direction while I was riding my bike, training and everything. I've only gone the opposite direction from the llama farm. We're not going to the llama farm. We're stopping before the llama farm. We're on an apple farm. A little bit of body roll there. But it's a racing van. You kind of want to feel everything anything and everything. If it's abnormal, you gotta correct it. That's why you wanna feel anything and everything here. Even the bounces, even the bounciness is good. I don't know if the camera's gonna pick any of the bounce up, but if you ride this van on a little bit of a rougher road, you'll feel that bounce. Lots of bounce. There we go, there's the farm 2 miles ahead. We're just gonna go in real quick, grab that slider, and then I'll show you how this van really performs in racing mode for like 2 seconds. Can't be having too much fun. Can't be having too much fun because there's some people out there who don't like to see vans having fun. Really anybody having too much fun. But especially not vans. Not vans of this size. Not vans that look like that people will easily get sketched out in, maybe. Gotta stop for that school bus. Safety first, kids. Like there's another stop. Oh no, never mind. Sometimes the doors take a little bit to close, I guess. Ah, yes. The school year is still happening. Looks like middle school, maybe? Middle schoolers, high schoolers? I'm not exactly sure. Probably middle school. That probably looks like middle school, quite honestly. Bumps. Instead of feeling a bump, you just feel bounce. Lots of bounce. Alright, here we go. Here's the farm. Get back on the interstate or get on the interstate. We were never on the interstate ever today. Let's get on it just for a little bit. We gotta go to Wally World and just pick up a couple items that we could not get at TJ's. Good old TJ's. Just a couple items that we just cannot get at TJ's. I'm gonna head up to Wally World via this interstate here. Should have a good idea of how this racing van performs. Oh shit, still in here. Cause that's how you gotta do it sometimes. You gotta race with some of your shit, or maybe even all your shit still in here. It's gotta be able to race, it's gotta be able to carry. That's what a racing van's all about. And it's gotta be fast. Let's give the beans here. watch the once we're allowed to change lanes here. Back in the Assvan racing van, made presented by Chevy. I guess we could say, yeah, presented by Chevy, GM, whatever. It's about to be the end of the line for the racing van, though. We have to return it. It's not necessarily our racing van, our times two racing van, but we've had a lot of fun in here. Sometimes maybe a bit too much fun. As determined by certain people, but I guess you can never have too much fun in here. There's a little aux cable taken from the headphones, the Beats wireless headphone bag. There's the other, the big camera cider. There's my bag. That one's a jug of maple syrup, Vermont maple syrup, from a sugar shack up there. There's the cider again. We got three giant bags of Trader Joe's. That bag just completely fell out. Just tumbled. There's two bags of Walmart. Again, there's a couple items that we just could not get at Trader Joe's. And then we got my other cycling equipments that I haven't unpacked yet from last night because... Well, we got back here, and I have to say I was pretty sleepy. I was pretty sleepy once I got back here, so it was, you know, get the stuff I needed for the morning out of the racing van, and then just leave the rest, and hopefully that it doesn't get stolen. And so far, so good. So we're gonna go back and unpack everything else, get rid of all the cardboard, duct tape. Our little engineered solution to load securement right here. Take note, white van men, and people who drive trucks, and everybody else, I guess, who will eventually end up with a racing van. Let's get back to campus, or really downtown, relatively quickly. It's not even all that far anyway. Because there's a good amount of shit to unpack. And I got some other obligations to take care of. Much fun as it lasts. It's gonna be a smoke show once we get back into downtown, though. That's all I know. I guess we'll be enjoying this little ride in silence. just get a feel of the air of this van. If you're watching a video, for me, it's gonna be bittersweet cherishment right here. I'm not even sure if that's a word. About 16:40 now, Eastern time. I believe this is just the tail end of class change for a Monday, Wednesday, Friday pattern. Yep, yeah, it's the tail end of class change, so everything should be dying down, you know, from all the crowds and shit, because of class change. Unless these people are going back to their apartment, which is, I don't know what I'm saying anymore, because I'm trying to enjoy the last little bit we have with the Assvan. Okay, finding parking in this area is going to be a little bit of a game. We shouldn't be too bad though. Shouldn't be too bad. Now my preferred whip around for a certain side street that we are hopefully parking on. Good. that's it. That's the end of the line for the Assvan in my hands, at least. Hopefully I have the opportunity to get another one, because this was an experience unto itself. I mean, as long as you're not alone, you know, as long as you're not alone experiencing this, it's a good one. So I'll see you guys later.